Hello and welcome, students. Today we will be discussing the Haber process. First of all, let's get to know how and why the Haber process became what it is today. Back in 1908, a German chemist named Fritz Haber successfully completed the process of combining nitrogen and hydrogen to produce ammonia by using temperatures rising from 400 to 450 degrees Celsius under a pressure of 200 atm. Develop this process, which explains why the Haber process is also called the Haber-Bosch process. Yes?
Sir, what's the balanced chemical equation?
The balanced chemical equation for ammonia is N2 which is a gas plus 3H which is also a gas to equal 2NH3 which is also a gas. Good question.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
Is the reaction carried out at a high or low temperature?
Good question, Zachary. This process is being carried out at a low temperature. This process relates to Le Chatelier's principle because they both have to do with change in temperature. A change of temperature is one of the properties in Le Chatelier's principle. Say, the temperature was decreased. This would respond by giving off more heat. So the more heat that is shown and presented, the faster the molecules will move around and bump into each other. This reaction will cause a forward reaction to take place, therefore producing more ammonia. Thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
That's Brendan.
Is the Haber process still important today?
Good question. This process is important today. In fact, it is used to create ammonia, which is used in fertilizer all over the world, which is increasingly becoming popular. Without this, it could cause famine all over the world. No more of these things.
Okay, I understand, but what catalyst is used for this reaction?
The catalyst is more complicated than pure iron. There is also potassium hydroxide added to as a promoter. This additional substance increases its efficiency.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
I actually have another question. Is the reaction endothermic or exothermic?
I'm glad you asked. This reaction is exothermic. Anything else?
I do have another one.
Okay.
Using Le Chatelier's principle, could you explain the conditions that favor the forward reaction?
By using this principle, you can accurately predict by increasing the concentration of H2 and N2, the products will be favored and the concentration of the product will also increase. Although, if the concentration of N3 is decreased, the dissociation of the product will result in the increase in concentration of N2 and H2 to restore the volume of NH3. Another method for favoring the forward reaction would be to decrease the temperature of the system. This would result in the heat being added to the products, increasing the production of ammonia. The final method for favoring the forward reaction would be to increase the pressure of the system. This is because a higher pressure means more molecules in the container. Therefore, the system can reduce the pressure by producing fewer molecules in the reactant side, resulting in the increased production of the products.